stereotypes of today. Like all my brothers eat chicken and watermelon, talk broken English and drug selling. Drug selling. See, I'm telling and teaching pure facts. The way some act in rap is kind of whack and it lacks creativity and intelligence. But they don't care because their company's selling it. It's my philosophy on the industry. Don't bother dissing me or even wishing we soften, dilute, or commercialize all the lyrics, because it's about time one of y'all hear it. Brown man, a vegetarian, no goat or ham, or chicken or turkey or hamburger, cause to me that's suicide, self-murder. Let us get back to what we call hip-hop.
About the chakras, remember I talked about Rick Rubin, I talked about the 808.
The chakras is real.
Now I'm gonna say some anti-Semitic shit. I'ma fuck your bitch, I'ma kill this nigga. 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 That's the real anti-Semitic shit that the Jewish people get paid off of.
I don't know what's this opioid thing, man. Well,
being a crackhead wasn't cool back then. Being a crackhead wasn't cool. Now they seem like they're making it cool to be drinking lean and syrup and
it's the most dangerous thing that's facing our society.
So why sign an artist that would promote that?
Because I already answered that question. You weren't paying attention. She asked me talent or issues, and I said talent. But I can't give up on people.
But I'm saying that's hypocritical, though.
You're saying it's opportunistic.
Yeah.
I got people to feed. I got a business to run.
You're gonna make Dame Dash take this clip and call you a culture vulture.
Who's Dame Dash?
It really ain't the rap audience that's bugging. It's one or two suckers, ignorant brothers, trying to rob and steal from one another. You get caught in the mid. So to crush that stereotype, here's what we did. We got ourselves together so that you could unite and fight for what's right. Not negative cause. The way we live is positive. We don't kill our relatives.
Pop, 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 when it's shot, who's to blame? Headline, front page, and rap's the name. MC Delight here to state the bottom line. The black on black crime was way before our time.
Took a brother's life with a knife as his wife cried, cause he died of trifling death. When he left his very last breath, was I slept, so watch your step. Back in the 60s, our brothers and sisters were hanged. How could you gangbang? I never ever ran from the Ku Klux Klan, and I shouldn't have to run from a black man, cause that's
self-destruction.
When hip-hop first came out, it had a purpose. People rapped about their situation and how to get out of it. And the other side of rap was having fun and bringing joy to people. Nowadays, rap is about propaganda and training people to act simple. The corporations have took over and using it as a marketing tool. Because people do what they see. Now we live in a monkey see, monkey do society. They put this stuff on TV and people copy it. All behind hip hop, and it trickled down from the top. Because this is the thing that I always wonder. How did Cardi B, a female who talks about WAP, get next to politicians? It's all a game of usury. The people at the top, the politicians, use the people to relate to the people at the bottom because they come from the streets. It's a genius plan that they came up with, and people would say there's no conspiracies. But hip-hop started off as positive messages and influential from the likes of Rakim, Eric B, KRS-One, Big Miss Melody, MC Light wasn't too controversial. And you had people that had points, and it was more about lyrics and messages. It wasn't about propaganda. Well, it was about propaganda. It was about leading us into the right direction. It was more of a positive vibe. now music has no feeling. It breeds a feeling, but it's not positive. I should say music has a negative vibe to it. It does have feelings because it's controlling the actions of people. But I'm going to go back to the beginning of hip hop when it started with the message. And now you have all this goofy stuff. And it seems like the past rappers were speaking to the future. KRS-One, the Wig Wack song about rappers with colorful names. And it's just explaining how goofy has become, because back in the days, if you didn't have your own style, you wouldn't last. You would be called a biter and be kicked out. But these people on the top, like you see Lawyer Cohen talked about the hip hop game and how Charlamagne exposed him for usury, just using the young people as fools and having them create the genre of gangster rap and all low vibrational music, because music is guiding the people. Words inside of a person's mind is a spell. And once these people seen it, for example, Lil' Kim and Foxy Brown started the raunchy rap period before Cardi B. Now we got this era and you see the decline in hip hop, because these people who are diabolical set out to destroy our communities, and we fell for the cheese because we can't see things and we can't think ahead. But when you have an enemy, they think strategically, the art of war, and they plan for years what they're going to do to us. And now you see the results of hip hop, and it's kind of plain as day as Kanye West exposed these people. You see the news corrupting him because they don't want us to think on a high vibration. So the liquor, the drugs, the woman, and all that stuff is killing our society because we can't think outside of the box. If you tell a person something, they'll, oh, you're a conspiracy theorist. Now look at how we are operating. And look what's on TV. Now everybody's gay and boys want to transition to be women. This is all through the music and the media. It's a big cabal, and we're just too simple-minded to see it. Back in the days, music had a more